Thank you. Thank you. Oh, wonderful. Thank you all. Good evening. Thank you. I'm really excited to have this opportunity to celebrate our students' graduation. And before we start, I would like to thank everyone who helped arrange this evening, set it up, Pam, Adam, Michelle, everyone. Thank you for your help. Wonderful job. So again, thank you all for joining us for Herron's 2024 Commencement Celebration and Recognition event. My name is Greg Hall. I'm the Dean of the Herron School of Art and Design. One of Herron's treasured traditions is having a live band perform at our graduation ceremony. Tonight's music is provided by the Circle City Sidewalk Stompers. I hope you enjoyed the band. We'll hear from them again later this evening. Let's take another moment to thank them. I'm thrilled to welcome you all this evening, including our guests who are joining us virtually through our live stream of this evening's event as we celebrate the class of 2024 and their outstanding accomplishments as they complete their current academic journeys. I also want to remind everyone that after the completion of this recognition event, you're all invited to join us for a reception at Herron's Eskenazi Hall. It's located at 735 West New York Street, just a few blocks south, but please join us. We're very honored and excited to be able to hold this event celebration here in the historic Madam Walker Theater. Built in 1927, the Walker Building served as the headquarters for the Madam C.J. Walker Manufacturing Company, one of the earliest and for years most successful Black business enterprises in the United States. The building's performance spaces were among many jazz venues lining Indiana Avenue. As the last remaining of these iconic buildings, the Madam Walker Legacy Center holds a significant place in our nation's history and is designated as a National Historic Landmark. As an important and integral part of the contemporary Indianapolis arts and cultural community, the Madam Walker Legacy Center is dedicated to preserving the legacy of Madam C.J. Walker by providing cultural education, promoting social justice, and empowering youth to become the next generation of entrepreneurs and civic leaders. We're so honored to be guests in this wonderful historic venue. Very good. So I would like to take this moment to acknowledge that we're gathered here this evening on the traditional ancestral homelands of the Miami, Potawatomi, Shawnee, Lenape, and other Native peoples of the past and present. We also acknowledge that IUPUI displaced the African-American business and residential neighborhoods of Indiana Avenue and Ransom Place in the 1960s. As a campus, we work to honor and acknowledge those who have cared for these spaces in the past, and we hope sincerely that its current use for the pursuit and sharing of knowledge and understanding, which are goals of the university, will lead to a future that is more equitable and just. So we know that many people have supported and contributed to the student successes we will celebrate here this evening. We're very excited to welcome the families and friends of our graduating students and everyone who has helped them to and through their academic journey. Let us take a moment to thank the families, friends, and loved ones of our graduates for everything they've done to help our students reach this important milestone. Before we hear from this evening's keynote speaker, I would like to take a moment to recognize Herron's world-class faculty and staff for their collective commitment to the success of our students. Please help me thank and recognize Herron's outstanding staff and faculty. Okay. Now it's my sincere pleasure to welcome and introduce this evening's keynote speaker, GK Rowe. GK is the Chief Experience Officer for Q7 Associates and the Chair of Herron's Dean's Advisory Board. As an experience-based designer and business design consultant, GK has successfully transitioned Fortune 500 companies and organizations to meet identified objectives, including capital campaigns, moving from decline to growth, and reinventing their identity. GK's design concepts and models incorporate neuroscience and psychological behavior of people in relationship to business, culture, experiences, and aesthetic environments. We're very fortunate to have such a talented and creative partner. Please help me welcome our keynote speaker, GK Rowe, to the stage.
Thank you, Dean Hall. And congratulations, graduates. When I was in high school, I couldn't wait for art class. My teacher was always working on something, and I couldn't wait to see her watercolor painting. I'd been eagerly following her progress. I stood at the door to the classroom in complete horror. She was standing over the utility sink with the entire painting shoved in the tub, with water flowing over it. We both watched her hard work and pigment fade away as it released from the paper, her with crazed excitement and me with rage. What have you done? You've ruined it. No, I haven't. I'm trying something I've never done before. I can always do what I've already done. I wanted to see what would happen if. Moments like these are what I have learned to collect along my creative journey. In that moment, she taught me how to embrace being vulnerable and how to take risk. Vulnerability is messy and it feels dangerous, but it's not as messy or dangerous as getting to the end of our lives and having to ask the question, what if? As students, you've already learned that potential and intentions are worthless without the courage to be vulnerable. It is that what if that keeps us inspired to keep going. While you've learned many skills and begin to pack up your equipment, your tools, paints, pencils, paper, and supplies, I suggest that you also pack up the wisdom you've gained that will help you to not only survive, but to thrive in the next chapters of your life. I want to share with you some of the experiences I have had along my life's creative journey and encourage you to reflect on your own journey and explore what items you would choose to pack up to take with you. So here is my journey and some things I've packed in my Thrive and Survive bag. For me, I took a few different detours in life. Before I owned my own business, I worked in corporate culture. And picture it. I'm 23 years old, sitting around a dinner table at a steakhouse restaurant with six men much older than I am, eating steak and drinking scotch and martinis. I think all of us are on blood pressure medicine or Viagra or both, one of the guys said. They all laughed. My boss nudged me. See what you have to look forward to? I felt like I'd stepped out of the pool on a cool, dark summer night, and I was all comfortable and dry with my wet bathing suit dripping off the side of the tub, and I was now squeegeeing that cold, tight fabric around my body to dip back in the still night water. The whole dinner experience felt like one big cringe. 6 months later, I quit, and I didn't have a backup plan. I didn't know what I was going to do, but I knew what I was no longer going to do. I realized that while I was in that job, I was starving my creative spirit. I failed to infuse my creativity into my work or supplement it outside of my work. I also learned that we ultimately get what we truly want in life. The problem is most of us don't know what we want. And comfort zones are where dreams go to die. Know what you want to do, but always be honest with yourself about what you don't want to do. I walked away from a well-paying corporate job, not knowing what I was going to do, but I knew what I was no longer going to do. Learn how to make a taco. Take care of yourself, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. Don't be so hungry that you'll eat just anything. I had to learn when it felt right to walk away from jobs I needed just for the pay, and also when to stay to make the pay. Knowing how to feed yourself will give you the confidence to define your own worth. And speaking of worth, if you put a low value on yourself, rest assured, no one will raise your price. Be honest with yourself and don't overinflate your price just to inflate your ego. But don't devalue your worth to make fast cash. Know what you bring to the table and what you can walk away with. and that may not be money. It can come in the form of continued education, knowledge, and wisdom. Know where you are and appreciate where you've been, and take the time to enjoy the journey. We all get older. Learn to be at the age that you are. You know how to be 13, 14, 15, 16. Learn to lean into the age you are. It's a gift. And speaking of gifts, many people will give you unsolicited advice along the way. You are lucky. You've been to art school. You know how to take criticism. Advice is nothing other than an alternative detour along your path. You can decide to take it or create your own way. You're the composer of your own life's design. Find your creative space. Take inventory of where and when you were along your life's journey that you felt most alive, and hold those places sacred in your mind's eye. It's a refuge. You can always visit these places in challenging times. So pack up your tools, your memories, your skills, and don't forget to pack your creative compass. While you are working diligently to learn the art of drawing, painting, composing, sculpting, among other disciplines, you are also learning how to master the art of healing by introducing to others a new way of seeing and experiencing life and nurturing your creative spirit. You know how to use a pencil to create a line that evokes emotion and also connect people to contemplate their own thoughts. You've learned how to manipulate material to take on a new form in time and space, and how to define a space. You've mastered the art of music, forging connections between people from different backgrounds. You've learned how to make the inexistent become existent. You're starting a new chapter in your life, and you will have a lot more responsibilities. You will have personal responsibilities and responsibilities as a generation. Together, you will be responsible for creating a future that I and many others will age into, and a future that you will pass along for others to do the same. So take a moment to take note of where you are right now, and not have to spend the energy thinking about where you're going. We spend a lot of energy and time thinking about what's next, but for now, I invite you to take a deep breath and celebrate you today. It's a moment where you don't have to worry about what is coming next, but a time to be in the moment, a time to live like your hair is on fire, show up like magic, touch the art, sing out loud, and leap.
Thank you, GK. We're very grateful for your inspirational remarks. Now it's time to begin our recognition of our 2024 graduates. We'll begin by recognizing students receiving their PhDs and master's degrees. This will include a hooding ceremony. The hooding ceremony is a unique recognition of the achievements of each student who has earned their PhD or master's degree. It will take place as they individually are introduced and invited to cross the stage. To help lead this process, please help me welcome Dr. Shannon McCullough, Herron's Assistant Dean of Admissions and Student Affairs, to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Hull. Hello, graduates. Are you ready for this? Yeah? Yes, let's do this. Each year, I have the honor of addressing you as we send you off on this next journey. You will hear from this, you'll hear this from all of us tonight, but it's worth repeating. You may leave our classes, but you'll always be a part of this community. Let us continue to help you as you emerge into this professional path, and further that path takes directions, we will be right there with you. We can't wait to see it. With that, now it's your time, so let's begin. Let me tell you how this works. Your advisors will lead you to the stage. As you come up here, you will hand me your card. with the phonetic spelling of your name that I am going to get accurately correct, and we will send you across to Dean Hull as you get your scroll. Please feel free to take a slight detour, necessary high fives, fist bumps, hugs, whatever you need. We are going to celebrate them, so let's get this energy up and focus on you, right? Let's do it. All right. We will begin the recognition and hooding of our graduate student body. As students from each degree program line up, I will call up my colleagues from our graduate programs who will hood our recipients. We begin with the doctors of the house, with the hooding of our Doctor of Philosophy recipients, and I welcome to the front my colleagues, Drs. Scott Deal and Dan Walsler, to hood our PhD students. First up, Dana Goot. Trey Young Mung. Harry Chabe. To add, I'm also proud to say that Harry is also the recipient of the IEPUI William M. Plater Civic Engagement Medallion. This award was established in 2006 to honor graduates who have excelled in their commitment to the community through activities such as service learning, volunteerism, community and social issue advocacy, community work study, and political engagement. The dean will now place the medallion on our recipient. Congratulations, Harry. And congratulations to our PhD students. Next, we have the hooding of the Masters of Arts in Art Therapy recipients. Calling to the stage, Professor Eileen Misluck to hood our graduates. Woo! Yes. Victoria Bonar. Larissa Baranikova. These are my students. I know your names. Keep on coming. Kaylin Cook. Abigail Downs. Dolly Thompson. Anna O'Rear. There we go. Yep. Aubrey Rhodes. And finally, Kate Rank. wondered about that one. Congratulations, Masters of Arts and Art Therapy students. Woo! Next, we have the hooding of our Masters of Science in Music Technology and Music Therapy recipients, calling to the stage Dr. Deb Burns to hood our graduates. First up, Peter Metzger. Phoebe Knees. Congratulations. Finally, we have a hooding of our Masters of Fine Arts and Visual Art recipients, calling to the stage Professor Don Holder to hood our graduates. Allison Ford. We like a certain height in our grad directors, not taller than me. Chloe Teal. Joan Wyand. Congratulations to our graduate students. And I'll call Dean Hull back to the stage to introduce our student speaker.
All right, thank you, Shannon. Next, we will present this evening's undergraduate student address. It's my pleasure to introduce Herron's 2024 undergraduate student speaker, Olivia Van Renderham, a 2024 graduate of Herron's Art Education Program. In 2023, Olivia was honored by the Art Education Association of Indiana with the Outstanding Student Art Teacher of the Year Award. I'm also excited to share that Olivia is Herron's 2024 Chancellor's Scholar. Olivia was selected by her peers and mentors to provide this evening's undergraduate student address. Please help me welcome Olivia Van Renderham to the podium.
Thank you. All right, let me make sure my cords are in order. All right. Good evening, everyone. My name is Olivia Van Renderham, and I've spent the last few years at Herron pursuing a degree in art education, certificate in pre-art therapy, and a minor in art history. When I wasn't staying up till 3 in the morning finishing a painting or a lesson plan, you may have seen me in the Herron Art Library, where I spent the last 3 years in a heated battle with the unnecessarily complicated printers, you guys know, reminding people to please keep their voices down because, yes, even in art school, people are trying to study, and sometimes, on occasion, checking out books to you. During my time at Herron, I've had the honor of being named Herron's Chancellor Scholar and Indiana Student Art Teacher of the Year. I also had the incredible opportunity to travel abroad to Thailand and Cambodia with Professor Robert Horvath and fellow students to study art firsthand, an experience that has profoundly shaped my perspective and approach to teaching. If this sounds like a lot of impressive accolades, just know I was originally supposed to graduate last year, so I kind of had extra time to figure everything out. Sorry, Mom and Dad's wallet. But hey, lesson learned. People change their minds. As we forge ahead, we'll switch paths, make decisions, and unexpectedly find ourselves in new situations. As creatives, we thrive on adapting, using our intuition and problem-solving skills to navigate challenges. Interestingly, a major part of my success has been anxiety. It's unusual to hear someone think their anxiety, but for me, it's true. It was an unsustainable and exhausting attempt to control my surroundings, but it taught me that I'm capable of big things. After a while, I realized I didn't need it to drive me. I am capable. This epiphany came to me during my study abroad trip while I was sitting alone on a roof on a hotel in Bangkok, gazing over an endless city in a place where I didn't even know the language. I still had this overwhelming feeling that everything would be okay. My anxiety didn't vanish on that roof, it still comes and goes, but that moment instilled a powerful new confidence in me that I carry today. Now imagine, we're all on that metaphorical roof. I know it's a bit of a stupid metaphor, I'm new to this inspirational speech business, and I definitely don't want to be one of those cliche, on my study abroad trip storytellers, but bear with me. From this vantage point, as we look out into the unknown, let's remember that this view isn't meant to intimidate us, but to remind us of our ability to find our way. We are more than capable of navigating whatever comes next. In studying both art education and art therapy, I learned that around the age of 12, most students begin to lose interest in art. This isn't because their passion has faded, but often because their artwork doesn't meet their expectations and they lack the encouragement to persevere. Reflecting on this, I ask all of us to think about the people who encouraged us along our journey. Think back to the first person who bought you that crappy art kit when you were 10, where everything was kind of dried out and didn't work, or the perpetually out of tune Walmart guitar, but it's the thought that counts. This person saw your passion and wanted to support you. Thanks, Mom and Dad. We are among the fortunate few who not only continue to pursue art through high school, but into college as well. There's something brave about choosing to study what you're passionate about in a world that values money and practicality, and often tries to push you away from less conventional paths. In a society that greedily consumes the arts, yet frequently underestimates the artists, it is crucial that we continue to forge our paths and pursue creativity despite the challenges we may face. Remember, the dullness, pain, and suffering in the world make our role even more vital. We bring color, hope, and insight into the spaces we enter, transforming not just our environments, but the lives within them. One morning while I was drawing upstairs in the hallway in Herron, as we all do, I ran into some guys studying, and from the looks of the math strewn across their papers, they were decidedly not art students. So curious, I struck up a conversation and learned they were engineering students. When I asked them why they chose to study at Herron, their answer was simple yet profound. We like being here. It makes us feel creative. I'd like to take a moment to thank a few people, including Professor Reagan Ferquin, who pulled me aside my freshman year and told me that I was capable of big things. You gave me the inspiration to stand here today. To Robert Horvath, who challenged me constantly throughout his class and inspired me throughout our study abroad course. To Kyle Kingan and Dee Dee Davis, for making the Herron Art Library a special and safe place to learn. To my professors and peers in the art education department, including Dr. Libba Wilcox, Dr. Jeannie Newman, Dr. Alexa Kalinsky, and S. Cole, for pushing me and inspiring me each day. Lastly, to my family and partner who supported me so much through student teaching. They let me lean on them when I needed it during the last few months. Thank you, Mom and Dad. As we step forward, remember the corny art poster that your teacher had up that said, the earth without art is just eh, because while it's kind of cringy, it's true. Congrats, class of 2024, here's to whatever's next.
Thank you, Olivia. That was well done, yes. So now we'll move forward with our recognition of our bachelor's degree recipients. So I will ask Shannon to join us at the end. Thank you.
All right. Wait till the captain ends. Okay, let's get this going. Undergraduate students. All right, Olivia Van Renterhem, Bachelor of Art Education. Emma McDaniel, Bachelor of Art Education and a minor in Art History. Tegan Blackburn, Bachelor of Art Education. Kristen Hamke, Bachelor of Art Education and Bachelor of Art History. Addison Mish, Bachelor of Art Education with a minor in Psychology and a Peer Art Therapy certificate. Katie Thompson, Bachelor of Art Education. Livia Cooley, Bachelor of Art Education and minor in Psychology. Kiara Smith, Bachelor of Art Education, minor in Art History. Aaron Updike, Bachelor of Art Education and a minor in Art History. Madison Morganette, Bachelor of Art Education. Not Heights. Sam Hitz, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Drawing and Illustration, minor in Art History. Trinity Hess, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Drawing and Illustration. Kaden Knight, ceramics. We're all BFAs right now. Cody Stovall, drawing and illustration with a minor in art history. Evelyn Stovall, bachelor of art history with a minor in philosophy. Audra Glotzbach, Bachelor of Art History.
I love you, Audra.
Aww, we love you. Caitlin Priest, Art History with a Certificate in Museum Studies. James Fuller, Bachelor of Art History. William Becker III, ceramics. Jordan Connell, drawing and illustration. Nicholas McCraig, drawing and illustration. Michaela De Palma, Bachelor of Science in Music Therapy with a minor in Psychology. Sarah Matthews, Bachelor of Science in Music Therapy. Alexis Allen, Music Therapy. Delaney Wilson, Music Therapy. Rebecca Ralston, Music Therapy. Melissa Deng, Music Therapy with a minor in Psychology. Trent Wilhelm, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Drawing and Illustration. Everybody looks so gorgeous tonight. Molly Hodge, drawing and illustration. Naja McGee, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Photography. Risa Hickman, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Photography, but minor in Forensic Science and Art History. Chelsea Walsman, Photography. Malaya Lee, Photography with a minor in Art History. Shelby Mattingly, Drawing and Illustration. Nina Greger, Drawing and Illustration with a minor in Game Design and Development. I know, right? No big deal. Billy Rios Aguilar, Drawing and Illustration, Integrative Studio Practice and Printmaking. Kenzie Rangstrom, Drawing and Illustration. Jillian Underhill, Drawing and Illustration. Abigail Brewer, Drawing and Illustration. Abigail Carpenter, Ceramics with a minor in Psychology. Alexis, Integrative Studio Practice. Alexis Rigney, I'm sorry. Integrative Studio Practice. You just need one name, one name. Sydney Money, Drawing and Illustration. Jen Scott, Drawing and Illustration. Hannah Schlatter, Drawing and Illustration. Teresa Hong, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Visual Communication Design. Drayton Travis, Visual Communication Design. Michael Surridge, Visual Communication Design with a Certificate in International Leadership. Leah Nelson, Visual Communication Design. Allison Krauss, Visual Communication Design with Certificate in Human-Computer Interaction. Marissa Eckert, Visual Communication Design. Lucas Cummins, Visual Communication Design. Ethan Grubb, Visual Communication Design. Tran Vo, Visual Communication Design. Elisa Shortridge, Visual Communication Design. Lauren Rutter, Visual Communication Design. Kenley Ligon, Visual Communication Design. Bonnie Marcello Escalon, Visual Communication Design. Lily Beechler, Visual Communication Design. Katya Halstead, Visual Communication Design. Riley Williams, Visual Communication Design. Chloe Etchen, Visual Communication Design. Sarah Brooks, Visual Communication Design. So much love. Keep it going. Elizabeth West, Visual Communication Design with a minor in storytelling. Neva Carter, Visual Communication Design. This is my maiden name, Sykes. Yes. Ayana Sykes, Visual Communication Design. You know. Connor Wright, Photography. Alexander Toms, Photography with minors in Book Arts and Art History. Corinne Lawson, Integrated Studio Practice with minors in French and Art History. Theoden Rowan, Drawing and Illustration with minors in Art History. Lillian Wassman, Drawing and Illustration with a minor in Art History. Genesis Salinas, Drawing and Illustration. Audrey Loney, Drawing and Illustration. Claire Wallace, Drawing and Illustration. Gabriella Odell, Integrative Studio Practice. Danielle Harrell, drawing illustration with a minor in art history. John Mark Kissidou, printmaking. Ollie Bame, furniture design. Walter Egan, integrative studio practice. Cam Maguki, furniture design. Lily Tomendel, sculpture. Katie Dorman, integrative studio practice. Sarah Schneider, integrative studio practice. Veronica Allison, painting with a minor in art history. Zoe Hodgson, painting with minors in art history and a pre-art therapy certificate. Sarah Miller, painting. Maya Ferzandi, painting with minor in art history and a minor in women's, gender, and sex studies. Keenan Tinnen, drawing an illustration. Amy Wooten, integrative studio practice with a pre-art therapy certificate. Lucy Smith, painting. Myra Church, painting. Abby Frank, integrative studio practice. Jane Jones, drawing an illustration. That's it. I love that. Ross Haston, drawing an illustration. Jason Smucker, drawing an illustration. Danielle Patrick, drawing an illustration with a minor in book arts. Sarah Bauer, drawing an illustration with a minor in book arts. Ross Noonan, Bachelor of Science in Music Technology with a concentration in Electrical Engineering and a certificate in Technology Specialist. Woo! Woo! I'm just saying, right? Come on. No big deal. Maxine Wilkins, Bachelor of Science in Music Technology with a, hold on a second, a minor in video production and German. There you go, go. Yeah, Hunter Ducate, Bachelor of Science in Music Technology with a minor in literature. Sarah Lopez, Music Technology. Irina Rezaeva, Music Technology. Cross Epperson, Music Technology. Zachariah Baumhofer, Music Technology. Daniel Alston, Music Technology with a concentration in Africana Culture and Music. Last. And last but not least, Lincoln Holm with a Bachelor of Science in Music Technology with a minor in Video Production. Impressive are these students in all of their academic accomplishments. You did it. Every title that I read, every concentration minor, that was your hard work. That makes you so diverse and enriched, and we're so proud of you, and you should be proud of yourself. So congratulations. We are going to have, I'm going to welcome Dean Hall back to the podium so you can stand up and let's move some tassels and make this legit, okay? Ready?
You go. All right, thank you, Shannon. If you'd like, please stand. And if your tassels are on the right, please move them to the left. Good. Congratulations. We're very proud of you. And thank you, Shannon. Really appreciate that. Well done. Okay. So go ahead and have a seat. Thank you. So each year, Herron recognizes one of our many alumni for their outstanding professional accomplishments and for the impact that they've had on the school, their community, and within their professional field. Celebrating the accomplishments of our alumni is wonderfully rewarding, and it resonates strongly at this moment as each of you begins your transition from your time as one of our students to your professional journey as one of Herron's alumni. Through this process, it's important to us that you recognize you are joining a wonderfully diverse and richly talented group of creative people who share this distinction with you. This evening, I'm very excited to announce that Herron's 2024 Distinguished Alumni Award recipient is Jordan Ryan. Jordan is a 2010 graduate of Herron's Art History Program and received their MA in Public History from IUPUI in 2015. Jordan is an architectural historian, archivist, and activist scholar, In 2020, they managed the Indianapolis Bicentennial Collecting Initiative and curated the Indianapolis Bicentennial Exhibition for the Indiana Historical Society. In 2022, Jordan was a recipient of the Indianapolis Business Journal's 40 Under 40 Award, as well as multiple honors from Indiana Humanities and the National Endowment for the Humanities. Jordan is committed to work that uncovers forgotten spaces in the city of Indianapolis and surrounding communities. Please help me welcome our 2024 Distinguished Alumni Award recipient, Jordan Ryan, to the stage. So Jordan, it's with great pleasure that we honor you as our 2024 Distinguished Alumni recipient. Your outstanding achievements have been a source of inspiration for your and your commitment to excellence and equity have made a lasting impact on Indianapolis community and beyond. We're honored to have you as part of our Herron family and look forward to seeing what other great things you will accomplish in your future. Congratulations.
Greg made me sound so cool, and I'm really not that cool. Yes, you are. I'm just an archivist. So I'm gonna cut my intro, because I had the same intro as GK from the watercolors to the Viagra, so I'm just gonna jump right ahead. So not to date myself a little bit, but the parents in the room are gonna understand the next part better than everyone else. When I was little, I remember sitting in front of the TV and being mesmerized by an MTV Video Music Awards speech in 1997, the first profound moment that really stuck with me. I'll censor myself because there are children in the room, but it was Fiona Apple's speech, "This World is BS." And I soon learned that the way I could cope with this world was through artistic expression and creativity in the physical movement of creating things that were beautiful to me. And sometimes only to me. I have failed, I have experimented, and I've grown from my mistakes, and I've come to realize that a better world is possible than the divided and fractured society we grew up in. So my time at Herron set me up for some great opportunities, fun chances, and many plot twists. From my humble beginnings at the Herron Art Library circulation desk 16 years ago, to now, being the first city county archivist for the city of Indianapolis, department of one with a 200-year backlog, but that's okay. I stand before you as evidence that anything is possible in our field. So if no one has told you, I'm proud of each and every one of you for surviving, for starting your education during the pandemic, for sticking with it during such an exhausting time. Don't let yourself be limited by the shortcomings of previous generations. You give me hope. Stay strange, stay weird, be curious, be bold, use your creativity for good to inspire others because a better world is possible. I dedicate this award to my lifetime research partner, Dr. Paul Mullins. Thank you.
Thank you, Jordan. Well done. We'd now like to introduce Michelle Winkleman, Herron's Associate Director of Career Services and the Chair of Herron's Alumni Engagement Committee. Please help me welcome Michelle to the podium.
Hi, everybody. I am also proud of each and every one of you. It has been, continues to be such an honor to be part of conversations about your future. So thank you for giving me the honor of doing that alongside of you. I'm going to keep this really short because I am very aware that I am the last speaker before Greg wraps this up. And I do not want to keep you from your celebrations. So I have two just really quick things for you. The first one is stay engaged. That's all we ask from our alumni. No matter where you go or what you do, we just want to know all about it. So come to the events, stop by when you're in town, no special event needed. Subscribe to the newsletter, follow us on social media, send emails to your favorite professor or advisor. Send us your news when you have it. Let us celebrate your wins with you, whatever they are. Don't forget about this community. This right here is the foundation of your professional network, and networking, as you guys know, because I told you already, is all about relationships. So keep in touch. The second thing is, we are still here from you. That relationship is a two-way street. And part of our commitment to being there for you is the fact that Career Services is still available to you even after you graduate. So that means that you can meet with me in the same way that you did when you were a student. A lot of you have heard me say this a bunch of times, but career paths are not a straight line. They are not a ladder with only one way up and one way down. If only if it were that simple, right? So if you need somebody to help you navigate your next steps, I'll be here. Okay, that's it. I promise to be short. Go forth, be amazing. We will be here.
Thank you, Michelle. Okay, please help me once again thank all of this evening's speakers and recipients. All right, dear graduates, today we celebrate the final steps in the academic pursuit of your degrees. I'm excited to remind you that you'll always be a member of an exceptionally long line of creative minds who have taken what they learned and experienced as Herron students and carried that knowledge and creative ability forward into every imaginable field. As you transition from our students to our alumni, please know that you will always be an important part of Herron's creative family. We look forward to continuing to be a resource for you where the opportunity to grow and learn is always available. Being a part of Herron means being part of a creative community with a richly diverse 122-year history. Every day, your work will continue to contribute to this story, and I'm absolutely confident that your stories will resonate with those that will follow. There's never been a more important time or a better opportunity to bring creativity, critical thinking, and innovation to the communities you're about to join. The world needs your optimism, empathy, and enthusiasm, and your unique ability to recognize and understand multiple points of view. We're so very proud of everything you've accomplished and of the paths on which you're about to embark. As you set sail from the harbor of our school, remember that each of you is a unique contributor to the majestic canvas and grand symphony of life. Regardless of your chosen discipline, remember that together you form a beautiful collective, each contributing a vibrant thread in the rich tapestry of universal experience, creativity, and human expression. As we move to the final stage of this evening's ceremony, I would like to ask that our students and all of our guests remain seated as the faculty leave the stage, accompanied by this evening's band, the Circle City Sidewalk Snoppers. After the faculty have left the stage, we'd like to have all the students come up on the stage so we can get some group photos. Again, I would like to ask all of our guests to please remain seated until all the faculty and the students have departed from this room. I also want to remind everyone once again that after the completion of this recognition event, you're all invited and really welcome to join us for a reception at Herron's Eskenazi Hall, just 735 West New York Street, so Herron's main building. So please let me say one more time, congratulations to the class of 2024. Very good. Be well and never forget that you are always welcome here. Now I'd like to invite the band to begin the recessional as our faculty depart the stage. Once again, to Circle City Sidewalk Stompers, congratulations, class of 2024. Thank you.